I gotta catch a vibe to the shit. Like, if I don't catch a vibe to the shit, I'm gonna be forcing it. Like, I ain't trying to force nothing, man. Shit.
All eyes on me.
Riding in the drop with my lady. AP fresh out the box, it's my baby. Hoes in my inbox on the daily. Might be the ops trying to sway me. Cause they see the watch so crazy. Diamonds on my neck looking kinky. A nigga been hot with it lately.
This one's for my supporters. From all corners. Offshore, cross waters, beyond borders. Got pre-orders from places I can't pronounce, homie. They fucking with math. They counting on me.
Yeah, yeah.
And actually writing a battle. Because if we look at Cannabis, to me Cannabis is nicer than all of those guys.
Right.
He wrote legendary songs, lyrics that was better than all of those guys.
Right.
But you saw what the happened with
right.
The disaster. Yeah. No,
now,
it's...
could Cassidy take out Cannabis if it was the lyrics just compared to the lyrics?
I mean, you know what? Let me ask you a question, right?
But I'm going to say this, though. But Cannabis is never coming back. I'm sorry, y'all.
I got you. The notebook thing.
I already know this.
But
I already know this.
Is performance really out? Does it out overshadow lyrics?
You got to be entertaining in your mannerism and when you even delivering it. So it's like, that's a part of what we, you know, looked at Fight Club. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Your flow, your lyrical content, and your showmanship. So all that packaged. And some people lack that nowadays. So as far as, like, let's say, like a Banks, you think that he won't have no showmanship because he's monotone.
Yeah.
He's not going to get animated. He's not going to get overdramatic.
Right.
But he's going to say some shit.
Yeah. In a small room. I want to see those two in a small room. I want to see Cassidy.
Oh, you're giving them the handicap.
No. It's a handicap.
Is that
you know, the big rooms is the wolves.
It is. You're right.
All it takes is one guy in the back, like, I know y'all not feeling it. Boo! And everybody like, yo, word, boo! It's over. In the small room, they'll have more respect. Like,
they right.
You know where the boo is coming from. You, right there. I saw you do it. You know what I mean? So they ain't gonna do that.
I feel you, but I just feel like the level, because the shit that they're saying, like you're saying, when you on stage, you gotta perform.
Right.
And that's the new age. You gotta have, like you're saying, you gotta have a whole package.
Right.
And you know, if you don't, you'll pull a Cannabis out there. It's 40 pages of rhymes in this motherfucker.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, I feel like in a small room, those two going back and forth, that shit for a lyricist, that shit would just be like a, I don't know, man. That's the upper room. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, I feel like Banks, and shout out to Banks, he's got a new project.
Shout out to Banks. I'm sorry. Yeah. I rock, yo, Banks. I fuck, yo, my G. Yeah.
That's a homie.
I'm sorry, you want the next, you gonna get a verse on that. You got a verse on that.
That's crazy. But I feel like Banks is lyrical, but as far as attacking, Cassidy attacks.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like there's certain battles where I feel like, yeah, it was lyrical. It was dope what he was saying, the schemes and all that, but it didn't lead to an attack. And Cassidy, he attacks.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I don't know who would, well, I don't think Banks would take that, to be honest.
Here's what I think, especially with Cassidy, because Cassidy,
Banks paying attention, bro.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
No, right, I know, now, I know he does. I've had conversations with him about battles, but
that Cassidy is the pioneer at this point for signed artists. And they're gonna watch how he's moving. Like I said, Cassidy's evolving every battle,
right?
And as he evolves, they're watching that same evolution. And I can say in his first two battles, he rhymed, and I liked the rhymes, and some of the balls was hitting, but it wasn't until after Goods that you seen that now he got some jokes. Because he joked that nigga and made him seem small.
Right. But I feel like with the right guidance, and I know as rappers, like, there's a fine line of... Got you know it. What I mean? Accepting advice from somebody else. Mm-hmm. Now, I know this for sure with Cassidy. Shout out to Cassidy.
Did we see Cassidy fumble or stutter in any of his battles?
Let me get some water, man.
Because that stage is pressure.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's
not like you performing for your fans, because your fans don't love you. But everything that you say is now being judged by everybody in the room. can you deal with that? I feel like the first battle, towards the end of that battle, I don't feel like he was like, nah, I'm not feeling this. You know what I mean? It takes your energy away. I think the Holla battle, he walked in there smiling. He's doing the boxing and all that. Like, he's comfortable now.
Yeah.
Now, for Banks to get out on that stage and do the same thing, I'm not sure.
To just be comfortable the first one out?
Yeah, unless you have, like, a battle rap. And I keep saying this, and I don't want nobody to take it as an insult. If you got a battle rapper with you, kind of like guiding you and practicing with you, because it's different. We write with our bodies.
Right. I mean, it's a whole thing with
you. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know how you're going to move when you say certain things. You know, you kind of, like, set up certain movements. You know, if you're going to walk around them, or you're going to be over here, or you're going to walk up to them, or you're going to be close in the face. Like, all of that shit is part of the performance, and it mm-hmm. needs to be practiced. It needs to be thought about ahead of time. Because if you don't, like, you know, you get the kind of, like, awkward just stand there, and sometimes that's not entertaining enough.
No, it's not really entertaining. It's a bunch of rappers that I love that just stand there that I'm like, you lost
that. What came to my head just now was, like, I actually just read 50 book, Hustle Harder, Hustle Smarter.
Mm-hmm.
And he mentioned in that book that Banks was lazy. Like, dead nice, not taking away no talent, but as far as work ethics. So to get on a stage in a battle,
mm-hmm.
not being in the booth, but being on a stage for whatever time frame you battling and delivering, like Matt was saying, you delivering that shit with your body and all that kind of shit. If you lazy in one area, don't even come here with
that shit. That's innate for, like, just being nice. You get too many compliments, it kind of goes to your head.
The ball's gonna be here for
you. And you feel like you don't have to work as hard as other people. I've met so many dudes that I was like, I know he's gonna get signed. I know he's gonna blow up. I know. And, like, nothing happened. Like, I don't know if you guys remember Axel from the Fight Club.
Axel.
Wait, which one? I remember O Solo and a few of them.
I think what he said, knock on your door like house keying.
Now your mouth's leaking.
You open up, your mouth's leaking. Oh, that dude. I remember that. Like, Axel is one of the nicest rappers I ever met. Him and Fred, I don't know what was in the stars when they was born, but these guys are incredible.
Yeah.
However, it's like, even with Fred, I feel like Fred was super nice, and he could put songs together, but it was just something that just kind of, like, you know?
Life. You're on the outside. Yeah. It's on the outside.
Rest in peace with Fred.
Yeah, bro. I mean... Yeah.
Shout out to the twins.
That's the Gordo, that's his family.
Gordo.
It's real. It'd be life outside of it. And I've seen a lot of artists. Because the words are starving artists. You're supposed to chase your dreams even when you're hungry.
Right.
But sometimes you're not afforded that. You got kids. So you could be a starving artist, but you can't be a starving father.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? It's
colder than that. Colder than night. I like that. You'd be a starving artist, but you can't be a starving father.
Can't be a starving father. So... You know, I've seen a lot of people that I knew had talent, but instead of being on the stage, they had to be at UPS.
But, I feel you there. And also, when the spotlight is on you, you have a responsibility to maximize that. And you got to, you can't mess up, like, that's your moment. Like, people are looking at you. Right. All eyes are on you. Yo, that's your chance right there, man. Show out, like show off, like, really go there. Because if you don't, then you'll just, people be like, they'll be lukewarm on you. And it might take you a minute again before you actually get another chance to come back and drop something that's actually substantive that people are gonna, you know, act rock with.
You might not have the same amount of people watching after that.
Right. You know, people laugh. Yeah.
Sometimes Diamond is in the crowd.
Jesus. Are you gonna go there? You're gonna go there? All right. Turn smack rapper, only smack rapper that you know is smack rappers. Got bars, I can hang with the backpackers. Trap star, I don't hang with the backpackers. I'm in the hood with the work, you heard. Making fiends leave earth, you heard. Got your baby mama thirst, you heard. Feel the flow, nigga, throw it in reverse. This the wave you need to surf, you heard. Yo, Jim, I need a bomb, I could drop on you niggas. Bad boy, I'm never gonna stop for you niggas. I don't give a fuck who you got, is the illest. I solidify my spot with gorillas. Now I'm rockin' you niggas. We'll be right back.